Hello everyone, welcome to Achiever CSIP tutorial. In this video, we are discussing arrays in Java. Before moving ahead, if you are new to this channel, please like, share and subscribe this channel to see more videos on this topic. Now we will start with arrays. So before discussing arrays, suppose there is one organization and there are some employees in the organization and you have to display age of those employees in the organization. In that case, what will you do? You just create an integer type of some variables and then you will input the values through user in that variable and display it. But this will be possible only if the number of employees in that organization are limited. What if there are 100 employees or more than 100 employees in that organization? So in that case, it will be practically impossible to declare and maintain those 100 variables. So here comes the concept of arrays. We can say that arrays are used to store multiple values in a single variable, and instead of declaring separate variables for each value, you can use a single name, that is array name, and you can access the different positions of that array to access the values. You can see here there are two types of arrays, that is single dimensional array and multidimensional array. First of all, we will see the syntax for single dimensional array. The syntax to declare array in Java is data type, then square bracket and array name. This is array name or data type, square bracket or data type and simply array name. This is the syntax, and any instantiation of an array in Java can be done with array, then reference variable equal to new data type size. So new operator is used to assign values. You can see here one simple example, int square bracket a equal to new int of 5. Okay, so this is a simple array of type integer. You can declare different types of arrays like integer, float, character, string based on your requirement. Now we will see how it looks in the memory. So this is the name of array in memory, and this 5 memory locations are reserved in the memory. And how to access this memories, or we can say the first element will be represented with index 0. So every array's indices will start with 0, 1, 2 and so on. That is, if there are 5 elements, then the elements will be represented as a of 0, that is a square bracket 0, a of 1, a of 2, a of 3, a of 4. So this is how the various memory locations of an array can be accessed. Now we will discuss multidimensional array. Multidimensional array is the array which are having multiple dimensional. In single dimension, only one dimension you can see here, that is only 5 value is there. In multidimensional array, multiple dimensions are there. So we can say that it is like a matrix or matrix representation, and these are the various ways of representation. Now we will discuss one example here. Example to instantiate multidimensional array in Java is integer, then double square bracket, then name of array is equal to new, then whatever data type you have initially used, that you have to write here, and here you can specify the size. This 3 indicates the rows in your matrix, and this another 3, that is the second dimension, indicates columns in the matrix. As we have specified 3 and 3 here, it will be a 3 by 3, that is a square matrix. Now we will see how the indices will be accessed. So the first index is x of 0, 0. This is the first position, x of 0, 1. This is the second position. And what we are doing here, we are assigning the values to the different memory location. So this is how various indices of a matrix will be accessed. And you can see here, the matrix form can be represented as the row, row 0, row 1, row 2, then column 0, column 1, column 2, and these are the various positions that you can see in this representation. So that's all for this video. We have discussed what are arrays, what are the different types of arrays, that is single dimensional and multidimensional. Then we discussed syntax of array, syntax of array declaration. Then we discussed multidimensional array with its syntax and memory representation. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel to see more videos.